The music industry is changing. There is a more circular relationship emerging between the creator, content, and consumer, with control shifting between them. The previous model was linear. The artist created a song, the record label controlled and distributed the song, fans bought the song. Then came digitization, making the music digital, which brought the opportunity for change. We could buy the CD, the MP3, or download the music video, all as digital files. We can listen, view, curate, create, add value, and promote the bands we love across a range of platforms. We have smartphones and tablets with simple apps that allow us to remix or add content without any professional equipment or training. But the fundamental change isn't merely technological. Academic Henry Jenkins tells us that convergence isn't about what you can do on different devices. It is a cultural shift that makes new connections between dispersed media. It is a change in both the way media is produced and the way media is consumed. We media mesh, we time shift our viewing, listening and commenting simultaneously on either one device or several. Our media isn't selected for us. Increasingly, there's no barrier between fan and artists. And this new fan base has what Jenkins would call spreadability, a personal stake in the content. They share it, add to it, spread it. We've become co-collaborators. The music you hear looping in the background? It's Convergence by 30 Seconds to Mars. This is a band who've survived a traumatic lawsuit by their record label and are now free to explore and develop their connection with the incredibly loyal fan base called The Echelon. The band uses them in backing tracks, album covers, social media vids, films, and more. In this new Convergence ecosystem, if anyone can find a way to make it work, they can. They're not alone. Other artists are at the frontier. Longtime innovators Radiohead released Inner Rainbows as an honesty box download, and they allowed a group of fans who'd never met to piece together concert footage from their smartphones for charity. The band gave them the official concert soundboard. Such frontier artists, including the multi-number one Pharrell Williams, know that control has shifted, and they're happy to share it with their fan base. Pharrell couldn't get airplay for his movie theme tune Happy. Then came the fan-friendly video of average people dancing to the infectious tune, which he promoted through social media. And the rest is history. The music industry will thrive. It will survive through convergence. So go on, participate, add to the cultural artifact, track down your favourite band, and connect, create, collaborate. You too can be part of the new music industry ecosystem.